Hi there, Simon from simonwood.com. A couple of Carmenères today, and I'll better see what vintages they are. Well, I'll do the youngest one first. So this is Aquitania Reserva Carmenère 2013 from Maipo, weighing in at 13% alcohol. Classic Carmenère, black currants, blackberries, a little bit of that coffee bean stroke green bean exotic character, some spice in there. Smells like it's gone ever so slightly jammy. Problem with Carmenère is it hasn't got very much acidity, so I don't know whereabouts they are in Maipo, but maybe if they're high up, then they can retain a little bit more acidity. But usually what a lot of people do is they'll either add some acidity to the wine or they'll put in a dollop or two of Cabernet Sauvignon just to firm it up. But let's see whether that jamminess comes through when I taste it. There's an intensity there. And I mean, I noticed that it's strange, underripe, overripe, the fruit that's been pushed and pushed to in order to try and eradicate some of those green edges, and has gone that slightly sweet, not too jammy, it's not gone into the really baked spectrum, but still there's this green edge there, a herbal edge rather than a herbaceous edge, and which in small amounts is good, in larger amounts it takes over the wine. Here, for some people I think it will be slightly too dominant. For me, Carmenère is a blending grape. I think it can work but well by itself, but I tend to prefer it in blends with other things. It's okay, and it's probably a bit better than okay. It's good, but it's not very good. Let's see whether we can do very good on the last one, which is Miguel Torres Reserva Santa Digna Carmenère 2012, and this is Marle. Val Central, so I don't know whereabouts in Val Central, but let's just give it a whirl. So it's got this bright dark fruit flavours, and I don't notice too much of the greenness that was on the previous one, but in with those bright berry and certainly blackcurrant flavours, there's this little edge of reduction that I just wonder whether yes, I almost want to pour it out and try it in a couple of hours' time to see whether that has dissipated. I'll give it another stir before I taste it. It's gone that little bit chocolatey. Sometimes I find that that happens with reduction. You get this toasty edge, toasty like chocolate wafer biscuits. Do they still make Blue Ribbon or Taxi biscuits? There's that type of character. And maybe I get some of that slight herbal character of Carmenère coming through when I taste it. Different style of wine. Which do I prefer? I don't know. I think that I'd be interested to see whether the Torres one does come out of its shell. I think both of them are quite good, rather than very good. I'll report back and see how they are in a couple of hours' time. So, for the moment, see you soon.